Shalom, Yashala. I'm gonna begin to sit down and say Barakafah, Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rokwa Kadosh. I'd like to also say double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone. Salutations to all of the sincere Akim worldwide pushing this truth. And the emphasis of this sit down is to believe in yourself, stay spiritual, and believe in the fact that Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai is gonna reward you for all the hell that you're catching for his namesake. All of the trials and tribulations that you go through are not in vain. And the Lord Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai is surely gonna avenge his elect. I hope to make this lesson as straight to the point and edifying as possible, and to give brothers an exhortation to just continue in this truth, man. Keep pushing. Yeah, I'm gonna start with Hebrews 11 and 1 on faith. It says, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen." In my opinion, that's very plain. What that's basically saying is that, ultimately speaking, we have faith in what we carnally cannot see but spiritually know is there, and that is Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, man, the evidence of things not seen. Because at this moment in time, in this lifetime we live, we unfortunately in this lifetime have not seen Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai face to face. In previous lifetimes, of course, as the scriptures will tell you, but in this particular lifetime, because of how far we've fallen, we haven't seen Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai face to face. However, through our understanding of the scriptures, the history, the prophecy, current events, we understand, man, that through that, faith, man, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai has dispensed onto us understanding to this of this truth. In a similar way that it was bestowed onto Simon Peter, that Yahweh Shai explained in John the 15th chapter and the 16th verse. Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Lord willing, we endure unto the end, has chosen us out of the world, man, and purified us. And that's the beautiful thing, because it says in verse 6, man, although, even though in John 15 and 16 it clearly says that Yahweh Shai has chosen us, we have not chosen him. Scripture also describes faith as being a gift. Yeah. Now, what you gotta understand is that only the Most High, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, can bestow upon you faith. But then, guess what? In verse 6 of Hebrews 11, it says, "But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." So that's being single-minded, knowing that Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Yahweh is the true name of the Heavenly Father, and Yahweh Shai is the true name of his only begotten Son. You gotta know and have faith that, Lord willing, you endure unto the end, you're gonna be blessed, man. You're gonna be beautified, you're gonna be exalted above the two-thirds and the rest of these nations. You gotta have faith that Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai is gonna bestow that upon you, because if you don't, then really you're just doing the work of the Most High deceitfully and in vain, because you're on that just in case type spirit that I like to call it, in the sense of one foot in the world and one foot in the truth. And just in case, things start to kick off, you're gonna just then try and lollygag and act like you were down from the beginning, when in all actuality the Most High is a discerner of the heart and the thoughts, man. The Most High will kill you for some shit like that, because you can't be playing with the Most High's word, man. The elect are going to be beautified, man, and that's why we hope to be a part of that, because we understand the promises to come. The scriptures say, "If I have not seen nor ear heard the things that Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai have in store for them that fear him," man. But according to Wisdom of Solomon, the 5th chapter and the 1st verse, it says the righteous man will stand up in great boldness, man. And that's exactly what brothers are doing on the four corners of the earth, going out in the east into east or societies, whether it be Babylon itself, America, and ultimately Jamaica really is just still an English colony in a spirit. We're out up in the so-called white man's world, cursing him up to his face, telling him that he's gonna go down. That's great boldness, man. Before the face of such as have afflicted him and made no account of his labours. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear, and they shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond all that they look for. Because even right now in this modern day society, for Jake to be rising up in the spirit and actually breaking down these scriptures, it fucks up the elites, because they don't have a logical explanation for this, because they thought that the nation of Israel was going to be done away with, man, and they could claim that Jewish status, that false Jewish status. But Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, pursuing to his promise that our forefather Abraham would never do away with Israel, man. And that's why were being raised up right now, the tabernacles of David, Yahweh, Shem, Yahweh, Shah, we all be a part of that. And in the spirit, a lot of scoffers are out there, man, because they don't believe that King David's coming back. They don't believe that brothers are the men of the Lord, but that's all good. Because like it scripture says in Ezekiel, the 33rd chapter and the 33rd verse, lo, when this comes to pass, lo, it will come. Then shall they know that a prophet had been among them. Yeah? Amen. It says, they shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond all that they looked for. Because these Jake out here ain't looking for no chariots. They're not worried about Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, being a so-called black man. They're just out here trying to work their 9 to 5 and go shopping and partying on the weekend. But it's all good, because brothers, you gotta understand, man, we've been bestowed with a great knowledge. That's why it hurts me when brothers are in such low esteem that they devalue themselves. Any man that gets to, you know, put himself in any sort of array with yourself is privileged through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Yahweh Shai. Any number of any woman you deal with, man, really, they're privileged to deal with you, man, because we're princes of the power and we're walking to the fact that, you know, we are Yasha Allah, man. But for the 2/3, man, they're going to see the glory of the Lord's elect, and they're going to be able to partake in it, man. It says in verse 3, and they repenting and groaning for anguish of spirit shall say within themselves, this was he whom we had sometimes in derision and a proverb or reproach. And then, hey, when you tell the truth in a wicked, filthy our society like this, even so-called friends are going to look at you funny. Because if you tell them, you know, that you ain't on smoking, for example, or you ain't on, you know, adultery or whatever the hell these niggas are doing nowadays, they're going to look at you like you've got 6, 7 heads. But really and truly, man, it's because this society is not righteous. This society is not built for us, man. That's why I just said, man, they had the righteous and a probable reproach. Verse 4 says, we fools accounted his life madness and his end to be without honour. And that's how these people view brothers, because they look at it like, all these years, all you've been doing is prophesying and teaching the word. But hey, that's all we got to do, man. You know, people are out here talking about own businesses and you know, run companies and make loads of money, put a deposit down on a house. This society's gone, man. Completely finished. Especially now with this Brexit shit. You can see Esau stressed out, man. They're always up in Parliament debating, arguing, but all of that is just for show anyway. Really, the Rothschilds, Rockefellers, DuPonts, the Gettys, those kind of families run things from behind the scenes, man. The scenes. But it says in verse 3, this is pertaining to the heathen and also Israelites, man, the 2/3. And they repenting and groaning for anguish of spirit shall say within themselves, this was he whom we had sometimes in derision and a proverb of reproach. We fools accounted his life madness and his end to be without honour. How is he numbered among the children of Israel? So like, how is he numbered among the children of Yahweh, Shem, Yahweh Shai, and his lot among the saints? Yeah? Man. Therefore have we erred from the way of the truth, and the light of righteousness has not shined upon us, and the sun of righteousness rose not upon us. Because, you know, brothers are supposed to have alternatives, man. But in the spirit, you know, sometimes shit happens, man. And you may not necessarily get to do what you intended to do. You might not be able to move to the woman you're dealing with. But that's all in the spirit, because if the Lord wants that for you, trust me, it comes easy. It's only when you try and resist the spirit and try and fight it or force things to happen, things don't really go down your way, man. The Lord Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, had mercy upon us, man, by giving us this understanding and this knowledge. He ain't gonna give it to everybody, because ultimately speaking, they're swine, and the scripture says, you know, cast not your pearls before swine, quite clearly. So you got to really understand that we've been given the depths of knowledge of the scriptures, man, and it's a very important thing. Don't walk over to a woman on some, hey, can I talk to you? Just tap her on the shoulder and say, yo, this is what the situation is. Are you down or are you not down? Really and truly, man, the elect, the Lord, the hopeful elect of the Lord, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, are blessed, man. Super blessed, because, hey, I mean, let me just quickly bring this out. With the book of Matthew's, the 5th chapter, it says, blessed are the poor in spirit, for they shall inherit the kingdom of Yahweh, Shem, Yahweh Shai. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Yeah? The meek shall inherit the earth. We ain't, brothers ain't, you know, of no worldly standing, but we understand that Yahweh Shem Yahusha has got us together to promote the word, man. And it's a beautiful thing. My brothers are staying spiritual, brothers are growing. Hey, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. It says, verse 10, blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Hey, the Lord has of Yahweh Shem Yahushua has given two tickets over. I mean, it's like a you know, Satan just got me, but no, the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahushua has got it to where even me myself, when I'm at work, you know, technically speaking, they're my enemies, but I'm able to supplant. That's the skill that we got to learn. Just make sure that, you know, we don't fall trap victim to these demons, man. There's a lot of wickedness on the planet Earth, man. And brothers just got to stay spiritual. It says, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see Yahweh Shem Yahusha. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of Yahweh Shem Yahusha. And it goes on, man. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And there's many a times that brothers catch hell, man. You know, with scoffers, work, family, friends, whatever the hell have you. But you got to stay spiritual at all times, man, because this is a living book. Really and truly, this is a great honor that's been bestowed onto us. We're literally, you know, like, honestly speaking, I mean, I know people, you know, brothers and people are modest, but honestly speaking, you know, man, you got to believe in yourself, believe in the brotherhood, stay spiritual, because ultimately speaking, the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahusha, watches over, man, you know, and it's important to make sure that a good impression is set. Get me? So, hey, man, I mean, the Wisdom of Solomon 5 is a good chapter. 6 on down talks about all of talks about the amount of debt compared to the liabilities on the page, and then submits it over to our case review manager to have a look. Brother's got to stay spiritual. Brother's got to stay confident, man. Believe in yourself, because honestly speaking, no one else out here can do it, brother. You know, we all gotta motivate each other. We gotta stay spiritual, and Lord willing, Yahweh Shem Yahusha will call me with good news. You know, hey, believe in yourself. Know that the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahusha got you. Stay spiritual, Akim, and stay strong. Until the next time, I say Shalom. Yahweh Shem Yahusha, Barakafon. Shalom.